Velkommen og god dag alle sammen. God lørdag. Today we are speaking about Årsgang. Now, Årsgang is a tradition in the Scandinavian folk magic. Årsgång is how you'll mostly see it. That's how it's in Sweden, but I'm Norwegian, of course, so Årsgång is the word I say. So we first have records of this being practiced in the 1500s in Sweden. And translated, it just means the yearly walk. And what it is it's basically a practice where once a year, usually around Christmas or New Year's, that you would take the walk in the middle of the night. And on this walk, if you did it the right way, according to instructions, and I'll explain these instructions in another video, but if you did this, you would see the spirits of the dead, you would have contact with your ancestors and their spirits, and you would get visions, and you would see prophecies and great wisdom for the coming year. Now, we read in many Swedish books about magic, all of this, and most of them claim that this is an ancient practice that goes back to pagan times, and they claim in some of these Swedish magic books, they actually claim that Årsgång is 1500 years old or more, so it's an ancient practice. So as usual, there are a lot of idiots, scholars and university professors included, running their mouth and doubting all the pagan origins of this, and I hear the same argument as I hear from them every single time. They say, no, this is absolutely not a pagan ritual or tradition. It was first recorded in the 1500s. Paganism ended in the year 1000. We have no record of Årsgång from pagan times, and there is no way that this could possibly be a pagan ritual. This is a totally Christian tradition because it was a Christian practice in a Christian time where Christian people were living. Well, no, dumbass. It's not. It wasn't a Christian time after the year 1000 in Scandinavia. That's when Scandinavia became officially Christianized. But we have a lot of records that paganism continued for a long, long time after that. And pagan magic would have continued for an even longer time after that. And the truth is that some pagan traditions never died out. We're still pagan today. We still celebrate things like Christmas, Halloween, Easter, Midsummer. These are all pagan things originally. What happened is those things were slowly Christianized to adapt to the Christian ruling power that was coming into Scandinavia. And magic is a perfect example of this, and Årsgång is another perfect example of this, and I'm going to tell you why. The origin of Årsgång, we don't know for sure. But in my opinion, I am 100% certain that this is an ancient pagan ritual called utesitting, and I think this is very clear. Utesitting, as we say in modern time, or sitja uti, I think they called it in Old Norse. I'll put it up here somewhere. Now, utesitting was a practice in pagan times. We have a lot of records of this. We know for sure utesitting was done in pagan times. We have records in the Eddas about this and the sagas. And what it is you would go out in the middle of the night, and you sat still. You would sat still, not speak, and you'd sit there all night, and you would sit at either a crossroads or a burial mound. And this was believed to awaken the dead spirits and gain knowledge and wisdom. So look, this looks like the exact same thing as Årsgång. But Årsgång was done in Christian times, and utesitting was done in pagan times. Årsgång was a walk, and utesitting was just sitting still. They were not the same. Well, actually, they were. Check this out. In the early 1200s, there were some laws in Scandinavia. You can read in some different logbooks, but Borgarting is one of them. And this is actually, we still call it Borgarting in Norway today. But a law written in there strictly forbids utesitting in the early 1200s. It was so forbidden by Christian rule that you would be outlawed for doing utesitting. Now, even if you killed someone in those times, you could just pay the victim's family a fee, and that was it. You weren't punished or anything like that. So being outlawed was a punishment for the worst of crimes in that time. You would be banished, had all of your property and things confiscated, you lost all of your legal rights, and if you ever came back to the area, someone could legally kill you. You lost everything. So it was probably the harshest punishment in this time. So utesitting was such a big offense to the Christian church, and they were so worried about it, they made it illegal just to go outside and sit down. Think about it. You couldn't even go outside in the middle of night and sit down somewhere. It was illegal. So the practice was exactly the same as Årsgång. You go out in the middle of the night and you believed to gain great wisdom and prophecies and speak with the dead spirits. And only thing is, Årsgång was a walk. But guess what? When this law came into place in the 1200s, people were forbidden to just go outside and sit down. So what do? Well, they didn't sit down. Like, as simple as that, guys, they didn't sit down. Like, sitting down in the middle of the night somewhere was one of the most, you know, the harshest crimes, and then would have the worst punishments that you could possibly get. So what did they do? Well, they don't sit down. They just keep walking. Everything else, they did the same. They just kept walking. And this is what Årsgång is. Everything else is the same. Even in some magic books in Sweden, they specifically instruct you during your Årsgång walk. You were supposed to walk to a church and blow in the keyhole. Like, blow in the keyhole. And this was believed that to renounce your Christianity for the night, and only after that would spirits and visions start coming to you. So it could not be more clear, guys. This is just another example of an original Norse pagan thing being Christianized over time. So many pagan traditions did not disappear. So much pagan magic and rituals did not disappear. They were just slightly adjusted to fit the Christian ruling power. So I'll go into that in a lot more detail in other videos. I'll speak a lot more about utesitting and Årsgång. So you can do this practice too if you want. And I also talk about all kinds of Norse magic and the myths and the real beliefs of our pagan ancestors. So you can subscribe if you like, and let me know if you have any questions, because the channel is not very big right now, and it's just started out. I just started the channel a month ago, so right now I have a lot of time to answer any questions you have. So if you have any, you can write it in the comments or send a message, and I'll try to make a video about it, or at least answer your question as best I can. That's about it for this one. Vi ses nästa gång.